Good afternoon, students. So today we start with the important topic, that is isomerism. So this isomerism. Isomerism is a very important topic in our chapter, in our second chapter. So what do you mean by this isomerism? Isomerism, if the organic compound, it has the same molecular formula, but they have the different structures. If they have the different structures, then we can say that these two molecules, they have the in the form of the isomerisms. The molecular compounds, they have the same molecular formula. Organic compounds, organic compounds, they have the same molecular formula, but they have different structures. So what is known is the different structures. There is only the difference between the arrangement or the attachment of the atoms of the group on the different ways. So there are various types of this isomerisms. All of this isomerism, they are classified into the various types. Classification. Classification of this isomerism. So this isomerism, they are classified into the two main types. That is, the first is structural isomerism. Then second is a stereo isomerism. These are the two main types, in which the isomerism is classified, and this structural isomerism, that is again classified into the classifieds into the chain. First is chain, then second is the position. Then third is functional. Then fourth, ring chain. So these are the several types of the structural isomerism. That is, the first is chain, then position, functional, ring chain, atomerism, and the metamerism. Same as the structural isomerism, stereo isomerism, they are also classified into the two types, that is, first is, that is, the geometrical and the optical. Geometrical isomerism. And third is optical. So it is a complete classification of this isomerism. Isomerism means the organic compound in which there is only the difference between the structural arrangement. They have the same molecular formula, but they have different structures. So this isomerism, it is classified into the structural and the stereo isomerism. First is structural isomerism. In the structural isomerism, there is a different arrangement, or they have a different structures, but they have the same molecular formula. But in a stereo isomerism, they have a different stereochemistry, but they have the same molecular formula. In the structural isomerism, it is classified into this stage, it is a chain isomerism. In a chain isomerism, the organic compound, they have the different structures in the form of the chain. Then position isomerism, in a position isomerism, they have the same molecular formula, but they have a different position of the functional group. Position of the attachment, not a functional group, a position of attachment of the chains, of the side chain. In functional structural isomerism, there is a difference in the same, they have the same molecular formula, but they have the different functional groups. In the ring chain, they have the they have the same molecular formula, but they have different structures in the form of the ring, and another is a chain, and the metamerism and the tautomerism. Same, this stereo isomerism, it is classified into the two types. There is geometrical isomerism. In geometrical isomerism, they have the different geometry, but in optical isomerism, they have the properties. If it is optical active or the second is optical inactive. We see one by one, it is first, what is doing with this chain isomerism. Or the first, we see the what are the structural isomerism and the types, or the what is the definition of the this structural isomerism. So first is chain isomerism. We see what is meant by this chain isomerism. What is example of this chain isomerism, and what is the definition of this chain isomerism. First is chain isomerism. So in this chain isomerism, so one thing is common, that they have the same molecular formula. But different structures. They have different structures. It differs in carbon chain. Carbon chain, that is it is a straight. If you take example, of the molecular formula, that is C4H10, this is a molecular formula, that is C4H10, but if we take the example or the molecules or the stereoisomers of this molecular formula, C4H10, so there is a presence of the four carbon atoms. These four carbon atoms are attached in the form of the straight chain also. So then it becomes it is N butane. In another way, more carbon atoms are attached in branched form also. So it becomes, it is a CH3, it is a CH, it is a CH3, and it is a CH3. So these are 2-methane. Propane. If we calculate the molecular carbon of this organic compound, we can see that there is a presence of there are the 4 carbon atoms. It is 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 carbon atoms. The hydrogen atoms are the 3, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a molecular formula. This is a molecular formula. Then molecular formula of this organic compound for the 2-methyl propane is carbon atoms are the 4 carbon atoms and the protons or hydrogens are the 3, these are the 9 and these are the 1, 4 hydrogen atoms. So molecular formula is a C4H10. So this N-butane, the organic compound N-butane and the 2-methyl propane, these are the two different organic compounds. First is N-butane and the 2-methyl propane. But these two organic compounds, they have the same molecular formula. That is, same molecular formula is C4H10, C4H10. So these two organic compounds are comes under the chain isomerism. Chain isomerism, because there is a in one organic compound there is a straight chain. Straight chain of the carbons. And in second, there is a branch chain of the carbon. So this is the example of the chain isomerism. We see the next isomerism. Second isomerism is position isomerism. Positional isomerism. Second is positional isomerism. The point is, it is the same, they have the same molecular formula. That is, molecular formula is the same molecular formula. But different structures. There is only the difference between deeper in position. There is only the difference between the position of same functional group. You have only the difference between the position of the same functional group. In the positional isomerism, in all isomerism, there is one point, it is a common, that is, they have the same molecular formula, but they have different structures. There is only the difference between the one point in every isomerism, or there is identification of, by using this identification, we can identify which type of isomerism is present in our organic compound. So in position isomerism, they have the same molecular formula, but they have a different same molecular formula, different structure, it is common. There is only the difference between the position of the same functional group. If one organic compound contains one functional group and the next organic compound, it contains the same functional group. So there is only the there is a difference between the attachment of this difference between the attachment of this functional group. If the functional group is attached to carbon number 1 in one organic compound, it may be attached to the next carbon atom in next organic compound. But these two organic compounds, they have the same molecular formula. So you can see this position of isomerism by using the one example. So this is alkene and second is butene. So these are the two organic compounds. They have the same molecular formula. We can write the structures of these alkenes. So these are the two, it is a structure of the butene 1e and there is structure of the butene 2e. So we can calculate the molecular formula of these two alkenes by calculating the number of the carbon atoms. There is a presence of the 4 carbon atoms and the atoms are the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then molecular formula of the organic compound is C4H8. So this butene 1e and butene 2e. So these are the example of the positional isomerism. So the functional group is alkene. So this carbon number 1, it is a functional group. This functional group is attached at position 1 and in the second butene 2e. This functional group is attached at the position 2. So it is a difference. This is the difference in the positional isomerism and the same it is molecular formula. So this organic compound is molecular formula is C4H8 and the molecular formula is C4H8. We see the next isomerism, functional isomerism. Third, in functional isomerism, first point is the same. They have the same molecular formula. But different structures. So what is the difference between these functional isomerism or the what is the different point is? So they are different in the nature of the functional group. Different in nature of isomerism. These two organic compounds, they have the same molecular formula, but they have a different structure. There is only the difference between the organic compound, it contains different functional group, and the next organic compound it contains the different functional group. In positional isomerism, they have the same functional group, there is only the difference between the attachment of this same functional group, but in a functional isomorphism they have different functional groups, total different functional groups. We can see the example of this functional isomorphism. This is a Michael formalized C3. Which is 6 O2, 3 carbon atoms, 6 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms. Then you can see that what are the functional isomorphism of this molecular formula. CH3, then this is CH2. So it is a propionic acid. Let's see them. So it is a propionic acid and it is methyl ethamide. The functional group is present in this first organic compound. It is an acid, carboxylic acid or the acidic functional group. This is acid functional group, and in next organic compound there is presence of the ether functional group. But they have the molecular formula. The same molecular formula, that is a C3. One carbon atom is more here. So it is a CH2. CH2, CH3, CH3, CH2. C double bond oxygen. They have the same molecular formula, that is C3H6O2. So there is only the difference between this functional group. Here there is presence of, you know, one organic compound. There is acid functional group, and in next organic compound there is a ether functional groups. So these are the three types of the our structural isomerism.